Welcome to a lesson on continuity. The goals of this video will be to define continuity using limits, determine if a function is continuous or discontinuous at a given point, and also to determine the types of discontinuity. When you took algebra, you may have determined if a function was continuous by determining if you could sketch the function without lifting up your pencil. If you can sketch the function without lifting up your pencil, it is a continuous function. If you cannot sketch the function without lifting up your pencil, it has some sort of discontinuity and is not a continuous function. We want to revisit this idea and also determine if a function is continuous at a specific point. Let's take a look at a definition of continuity involving limits. A function f is continuous at x equals a if it satisfies these three conditions. F of a exists, the limit of f of x as x approaches a exists, and also that the limit of f of x as x approaches a is equal to f of a, meaning you can find the value of that limit by performing direct substitution. A function is continuous over an interval if it is continuous at each point in that interval. Before we look at some examples, let's talk about two types of discontinuity. Here are two functions that are not continuous. They contain discontinuity. Now this first function, you can see, it's really only discontinuous at this point. If I was to take this point and move it back down into this position, it would then make the function continuous. This is called removable discontinuity. F of x can be made continuous by appropriately defining or redefining f of c. Now this function could not be made continuous by redefining a single point. You can see here that it has a vertical asymptote. This is called non-removable discontinuity. F of x cannot be made continuous by redefining f of c. This type of discontinuity occurs when the limit does not exist at c. Let's take a look at an example. Determine if the given function is continuous at x equals negative 2, 2, and 4. Let's first consider x equals negative 2. So we're looking at the function in this region here. And remember, we want to state if it is discontinuous, which it looks like it is, what is the reason behind it being discontinuous? So I rewrote the three conditions down here that we can verify. First, f of a exists. Well, in this case, f of a would be f of negative 2, and f of negative 2 would be equal to a negative 1 from our graph, so it satisfies that condition, okay. The next condition, the limit as x approaches a must exist. So we're trying to figure out if the limit as x approaches negative 2 exists. Remember, to determine this limit, we must approach negative 2 from both sides. The right-sided limit looks like it's approaching positive 1. The left-sided limit looks like it's approaching negative 1. Therefore, this limit does not exist. Therefore, we have a function that is not continuous at x equals negative 2. And in fact, this would be non-removable discontinuity because we could not make it continuous by just redefining this one point. Let's now consider this function at x equals 2. So now we're concerned about the function at this point. So again, we must satisfy these three conditions, and right off we could say that f of 2 does not exist, therefore we have a function that is not continuous at x equals 2. But the type of discontinuity here is removable. If we were to redefine f of 2, we could make this function continuous. Take a look at it at x equals 4. At x equals 4, let's see, does f of 4 exist? It does. It looks like it would be equal to positive 2. Next, we need to consider the limit of this function as x approaches 4 and see if this exists. As we approach 4 from both the right side and the left side, we can see that we are going to be approaching this closed point here. Therefore, this limit will be equal to positive 2. So we verified that f of a exists. we verify the limit exists, and now we need to make sure that we can find this limit by doing direct substitution. The last thing we need to verify is that the limit can be found by performing direct substitution, in this case, when x is 4. So notice now that f of 4 is equal to 2, and the limit is also equal to 2. Therefore, this confirms that this function is continuous at x equals 4. Okay, I hope that helps explain how to determine if a function is continuous at a given point, and also to determine what type of discontinuity might exist. Thank you for tuning in.